Eric Carmen and Sunrise. Good morning, this is Beacon Radio. My name is Mike Baker, and it's 7 minutes past six.
Mike Baker.
That's the sound that went on the airwaves this morning over the Black Country. Beacon Radio 303, the latest and for some time the last of the new commercial radio stations. Broadcasting on 303 metres in the medium wavelength and 97.2 stereo, the station will serve 1.25 million people in the West Midlands. Based in an old house near the centre of Wolverhampton, Beacon 303 will operate for 19 hours a day. But unlike the other commercial stations, it will aim for a new mixture of music and news. The managing director, Jay Oliver, explains.
All the areas tend to be different. And so instead of trying to cater for any one area, which is the hardest thing to do, we've put together a type of programming which will cater for the whole area.
The man responsible for putting together Beacon's new concept of presenting news, music and information together is programme controller Alan McKenzie.
And we're avoiding at this stage any form of what are conventionally called programme blocks. You know, there's no sort of real soul show, there's no country and western show, there's no real religious programme, there's no ethnic programme. We are mixing all of those elements right throughout our entire programme day. And I was quite surprised on one occasion, you know, when I was talking to a local resident about this, and he said, well, you know, you're probably right in many ways, because did you realize that in the primary area alone, which of course is the four major centers, that is Walsall, Wolverhampton, Dudley and West Bromwich, that there are 18 different dialects? Now how could I cater? I mean, I must upset somebody. So in terms of voice presentation, we've also gone for a fairly neutral English voice.
This is Beacon Radio 303, an independent local radio station serving the West Midlands. The company is owned and operated by Beacon Broadcasting Limited, PO Box 303, Wolverhampton WV6 ODQ.
We've come up with a thing called News As It Happens. We will mix that with a news on the hour, which we will take from independent radio news. That'll be national and international news. And then in the hour, depending on what happens in the hour, we will come into the programming and integrate into the programming news bulletins as there is news that merits being aired. And that's mainly local, but it can be national. If it's a national story of interest to the people in the area, then we will bring the update so that they don't have to wait till on the hour to get it.
And the former editor of the Wolverhampton Express and Star, Clem Jones, is the man responsible for making sure the station gets the news out as it actually happens.
No, that's the thing I like. I like challenges and I like the excitement of being able to do that. You can't do that on a newspaper. You have to wait until edition times, and not only wait until edition times, but you have to wait until the delivery vans, at least from the reader's point of view, have taken the papers and newsboys have put it through the letterbox. We go straight through the transistor radio.
I feel that after a year in the Black Country, I certainly, myself, feel that I'm part of the Black Country. It's my home now. And I hope that the people of the Black Country feel that I'm part of it, and that the radio station will certainly be part of it. I wanna stay.